A substantial amount of earthquake damage in Christchurch has been due to rockfalls from bluffs and cliffs in different parts of the city. These have sent large boulders into properties and buildings nearby. We're just pulling up to the end of Raikoura Place, where we're going to laser scan a rock face. Part of our work here at GNS is to make detailed observations of these cliffs and bluffs to see if they are still unstable, or will perhaps be further destabilised by further aftershocks. We then assess the ongoing risks to properties and roads at the base or near the top of these outcrops. Now, I was here about a week ago and we did an initial scan. And so by doing this repeat scan, we can look at the changes between them and we can see whether the cliffs are deforming or not. This laser scanner is one of the tools we use. It sends a large number of laser pulses in a grid across the cliff face at a rate of up to 11,000 per second. The pulses are reflected back to the scanner and the return time gives an accurate measure of the distance to each point on the cliff surface. And it's had significant rockfall from both the September and February earthquakes. Since then we've had sporadic small rockfalls from just stuff that's sort of clinging on. You can see there's cracks forming behind some of the rocks, but we're not really interested in looking at the small rockfalls. We're looking for broad scale movement across wider areas that might indicate bulging or toppling or some larger movement, more deep-seated movement that's situated behind the cliffs. The laser rotates across the face and we try to aim for a total file of around about 10 million points. Usually we make scans from more than one location to get a good coverage of all the surface features so that we can make a comparison between them that will show change through time. The changes may be precursors to some larger movement which might be leading to failure of the slope. This tells us if there's been any movement of the face, such as bulging or tipping, that may indicate a further risk of rockfall or landslip damage. In this example from Redcliffs, very little change is indicated, which means that apart from smaller areas where loose rocks come down, we are not seeing any large-scale movement at present.